biomarker, and we were working on. EPS. EPS, actually, when I first came here, no, prior to coming here, I was able to get some really big money using biomarkers, big grant. And I was actually a professor of chemistry at University of Nevada, Las Vegas. Dr. Wilson said that I was postdoc in Berkeley, but then they hired me in University of Nevada as a professor, research professor of chemistry. And I was able at the time to obtain a large, really mega grant, you know, millions of dollars. When Dr. Wilson invited me to come, I was lucky to convince people, he also participated in that, to transfer the grant from University of Nevada to Houston, to here, to TSU. And we were able to transfer everything from it. So this was the big money at that time, you know, talking about 2 million or so, you know, real big money. That was the money that was able, in addition to the support I got from Dr. Wilson, to create a laboratory in the old building where we had same type of equipment that I have now, but at that time, you know, 25 years ago, they were, of course, now, you know, they're much older. So the same, we had GCMS, we had HPLC, everything. So now we replaced it with much newer, updated equipment. But we had this kind of capability since I came 25 years ago. And this work was part of the work that was done by Blancato is now one of the real top EPA officials. Dr. Wilson, you met him when we first met, Jerry Blancato. Now the QSR is what is the relationship between structure and activity? And the structure is the most important thing in chemistry. If you know the structure of something, then you can find out how the chemical behaves. You can do structure activity with regard to the physical, is the chemical. I can look at the chemical and say this has to be liquid, or this would be gas, or this would be solid, or this would be toxic, or this would be non-toxic. This would enhance your anti-cancer activity. And so once you correlate structure to activity, you can have power to anticipate how things would happen. And we do that with something called molecular modeling. So for example, I had students here who were very good. Brooke Woodward looked at the different chemicals and how can they actually fool the bacteria. You know, we did structure-activity relationship